As we wind down the Paschal Tide, we have very few days left before Ascension Thursday, when our Lord ascends into heaven, the Paschal candle will be removed from the sanctuary. And as we get towards the end of the Paschal season, it would be good for us to do a quick examination, if you will, of this past Paschal Tide. Now, unfortunately, it happens that while we would be going strong during Lent spiritually, doing all kinds of extra prayers and penances, when we get to the Easter time, we sort of loosen our belt and let the flag hang out once more. We allow ourselves to become a little bit more complacent in the spiritual life, and a little bit of relaxation during the joyful time is not exactly a disorder, but oftentimes we go a bit too far. And perhaps you might find that when you were in Lent, and you were doing all kinds of fasting and prayers and different mortifications, you found yourself feeling a little bit holier than you were the rest of the year. Now, why is it? We ask ourselves these questions. I include myself in this as well. Why is it that we take such great pains to be holy during Lent, and then when our Lord ascends and rises from the dead, in the most solemn time of the year, the Paschal time, we don't take our spiritual life quite as seriously. Now, why is that? Because if you think about what Lent is it preparation? And what are we preparing for the most solemn feast of our liturgical year, the resurrection of our Lord. And this most solemn feast is what we should be aiming for. This is the other thing that we are trying to go for. So, if we are in the most important time of the liturgical year, why is it that we don't have the same level of enthusiasm in the spiritual life that we did back in Lent? Now, I'm just assuming that this is the case. Now, if it is the case, then what can we do about it? So, perhaps the intense fasting that we have in Lent would be a little bit excessive during a joyful time that is not penitential. However, it doesn't mean that we need to leave off all penance altogether. And it doesn't mean that we need to skip all kinds of devotions that we did before. Because after all, what is better? What would be a better way to spend this Paschal time than by extra prayers in the presence of our Lord, meditating upon those five wounds on his hands, his feet, and his side, in his risen body? Imagine what it would be like to be one of the disciples, there seeing our Lord risen from the dead, walking amongst them. Now, although it was definitely a sight to behold, our Lord risen from the dead, and speaking to his apostles, speaking to his disciples, I wonder, did any of them take for granted? Did anyone take our Lord for granted that he was among them? And then when the Ascension Thursday came up, they were completely shocked. What in the world is going on here? We thought he was going to be with us forever. Why is he leaving? No. If they had spent that time well with our Lord, perhaps it wouldn't have quite been all that shocked, because every moment that our Lord gives for us is a blessing. And every moment that we live upon this earth is a blessing. It is a gift from God. You know, those who have had brushes with death consider every single day that they live past that death point as a blessing, as a gift that God has given them. I knew a man who had eight strokes, and at one point, one of those strokes, I wanted to say it was five or six, put him in a coma for several years, and people weren't really sure if he was ever going to come out of it, and eventually he did, and he came back. He wasn't completely there after eight strokes, I don't exactly blame him, but you know, he was definitely alive and well. And definitely grateful for the gift that God had given them to be able to be alive. Now, it was truly an edifying thing, just simply being in the room with him, because he lived every day as if it were his last. He said, "I deserve to die, I deserved to die. I had so many sins in my soul. You know, I used to be an atheist. Even after being an atheist, I was a Baptist, but fire and brimstone anti-Catholic Baptist, and then eventually made his way to the Catholic Church. Now he's a fire and brimstone Catholic, you know, nice and good and perfect. But he said that at any moment God could have snuffed me out, and in fact I deserved to die. And the fact that I am standing here and living today is a grace from God. And so, if he has given me my life, I give God mine. That's the thing that he says. I'm not exaggerating. This guy was, he made me look lazy. And, well, it's not that hard to do, but, if, you know, but he would spend such time in prayer that I always felt that I needed to do a little bit more when he was watching, just simply because of how intense his fervor and love for God was and is. Now, if you were to take every day as if it were a gift from God, which it is, and if you were to say that every day that I get to spend in the presence of our Lord is a grace and a privilege that I will never get again, what would that Easter look like if you went into it with this mindset? What would the rest of this Easter season look like if you started it today, if you haven't already done so? Imagine what would happen. Every day of our life, we spend as though it were a gift from God, given directly by our Lord's hand, straight to us. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the prayer that we have very often in the octave of Easter, a dies Confessor Dominus. If you have this mindset within us, that this is the day the Lord has made, let us rejoice and be glad in it. Let us take these final days of the Easter season, while our Lord's presence, symbolized by the Paschal candle, burns brightly in the sanctuary. Let us take every day as a gift from God. Let us not decrease our fervor just because we no longer are in the penitential season. Let us increase, because after all, if our Lord is with us, what else do we need? May our Blessed Mother help us to take these final days in contemplation of our Lord. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. Padre,